Hi, everybody. I am Dr. Perkins. I am a board-certified OBGYN, and today we're talking about, can a woman get trichomoniasis on her own? I'm excited to dive into this topic with you. Today, we will learn about the common ways that trichomoniasis can be transmitted and other ways that research has shown that this infection can be transmitted to a woman. Let's dive into this information today. Let's first talk about what trichomoniasis is and how it is spread. Now, often you will hear trich as a short for trichomoniasis, and I might use that term in our conversation today. Trichomoniasis is a parasite. This infection is very, very common. In fact, more than 3 million males and females every year are infected with trichomoniasis. This organism is extremely contagious, and most people do not have any symptoms at all. Because of this, spreading this infection is very easy and continues to be a problem. This infection is more common in women, and actually only about 30% of people show any symptoms of this infection. Trichomoniasis is most commonly spread through vaginal and penile contact. The infection can spread to the cervix or the urethra. For the people who do show signs and symptoms of this infection, this often will present at approximately 3 weeks after the infection has occurred. Symptoms may include vaginal discharge changes, which is really the most common way that people may find out or may know that something is different within their body. This discharge could be green, yellow, and could be a lot more in quantity. Sometimes this discharge change may also come with a bad odor. In males, they may notice that they have a white discharge coming from the penis. Other symptoms are very generic. You may have itching and burning when you urinate. You may have pain with sexual intercourse. You may even have some swelling in the genital region. I'm so glad you're still here as we're discussing trichomoniasis and ways that a woman can get this infection. If you're enjoying our conversation today, please subscribe and like this channel. Now let's talk about what are some of the non-sexual ways that this infection can spread. There has been research that trichomoniasis can actually be spread in non-sexual ways, but the support with this and evidence of this is very slim. While we will talk about these, know that more research is needed to know whether or not this infection is actually spreading in this manner. There has been small reported cases of this infection spreading from toilets. Now, that could be by having any type of specimen or any type of bodily fluid present on toilet seats. That could be urine, could be feces, it could be discharge that is on the toilet. What we do know is that this parasite can live outside of the body for 45 minutes to sometimes hours after it has been released from the body. It is very important that you cover the toilet seats or try not to be in contact with them if you're using a public toilet to kind of limit or reduce the likelihood of this infection spreading in a non-sexual way. There's a small subset of research that has also shown that trichomoniasis can spread through baths, shared baths. Now, it's still unknown whether or not heated baths makes a difference versus cold, and more research is needed to let us know whether or not trichomoniasis lasts longer or shorter in certain types of baths. Now, please take this information with a grain of salt because, again, lots of research is needed in this area. A third area that some research has shown that this infection can spread is in public pools. Now, there is also some skepticism here because between pools being cleaned regularly, chlorine being present in pool water, we're still unsure of the likelihood of this infection surviving or this parasite surviving under these conditions. More information is needed regarding whether or not this parasite survives in these pool conditions and to what degree pool water enters into the genital space, the vagina, to cause an infection. Lastly, a very small few research studies have shown that trichomoniasis may survive on wet or dampened towels and clothing. Now, those were four different ways that research has shown that trichomoniasis can be spread outside of sexual activity. So today we talked about trichomoniasis and non-sexual ways that this infection can spread to women. If you enjoyed our conversation, please do click the link below. At that link, I'm sharing with you a free copy of my book, Hormones Don't Lie. Thank you for being here. Thank you for sharing the space together. And I look forward to seeing you as we discuss more topics about your body.